Why does the new Lupin series feel so familiar? Why is Omar Sy so attached to his character? And was the epic art heist really shot at the Louvre Museum? Hello, my name is Joy, and it's time to lift the veil on Netflix's most watched show. And yes, it's better than Bridgerton. Meet the anti-Sherlock Holmes. For the first time in Netflix history, the spotlight is on the French. Wait, Loop who? Let's make things clear. If the Queen's Gambit made us wish we were good at chess, Lupin is about to make us want to be literary heroes. In fact, the series was inspired by a book character from a classic French tale. He's a gentleman burglar, a master of disguise, stealing from those who deserve it. No violence, just persuasion. Created by a French writer, Maurice Leblanc, in 1905, Lupin also stole the hearts of readers and inspired creators all over the world. The gentleman is an internationally renowned figure, known for more than just his French heritage. He's also experienced numerous French adaptations, the last being the splashy film with Romain Duris and Eva Green. Now it's time for a contemporary twist. I liked the gentleman burglar aspect a lot, but I wanted to subvert it and give it a social angle, said Louis Leterrier, who directed the first three episodes of Lupin. I found the idea of a 6'2" black man sneaking around in both high society and the underworld interesting. The 2021 version of the gentleman burglar leaves the confines of the Belle Époque to explore new territories. However, reinventing the myth wasn't the easiest challenge. George Kay, scriptwriter of the hit series, wanted to put the spotlight on France and ask how the country has evolved since these stories were written. How can a character like Assane Diop meet the more traditional world of Arsène Lupin? And how can one play with this? He tells Allociné, "I asked myself at the end, how would Arsène Lupin adapt Arsène Lupin?" Stay tuned to learn how the original cast helped to realize these dreams. Two French treasures in one series. The fictional pilferer is not the main character of the French Netflix series, as you know. That's Assane Diop, a Parisian who lives and breathes the Lupin stories. He's embodied by a charismatic Omar Sy, and I bet you've seen him before. A César, or French Oscar award, for the cult blockbuster film The Untouchables started his budding Hollywood career. He also played the mutant hero Bishop in X-Men Days of Future Past and took care of Velociraptors in Jurassic World. In addition, he had a much cuddlier companion in The Call of the Wind. But how did Omar end up in Lupin? Actually, the powerhouse film company Gourmand, in collaboration with Netflix, asked him what his dream role was. Oh yes, he's that cool. Omar immediately thought of his favorite manga based on the book. If I were British, I would have said James Bond, but since I'm French, I said Lupin. He confessed in a recent video call in French from his Los Angeles home. He's playful, he's clever, he steals, he's surrounded by women, plus he's a character who plays characters. For an actor, he's the best. As Lupin, he never kills, instead using his knowledge of Hapkido, the martial arts form in which you use your adversary's own force against them, so you never attack, you just send back. In fact, the series was written as much for Omar as for Lupin. Two French treasures in the same series, points out George Kay. Well, we've actually noticed another treasure, but we'll talk about that later. For an actor, it's great fun to be able to take on this character and wander through different social classes. Lupin was a keen observer of society, and he wanted Arsène to be the same, Sy said. He doesn't need much to disguise himself. He joins the type of people who don't get noticed, and he disappears. To prove this complex issue, Netflix France recently released a controversial campaign in which Omar Sy put up a poster of Lupin at the Musée du Louvre station, one of the major locations of the series. Wearing a blue fleece jacket and construction shoes, the renowned actor wasn't noticed by the passengers waiting on the platform.
Prouver qu'au-delà de la fiction, même dans la vraie vie, parfois on voit, mais on ne regarde pas.
Beyond the comic dimension of this promo, some internet users saw it as a powerful social experiment, underlining the lack of consideration for the invisible workers in our society, like cashiers, delivery men, and cleaners. And that's what Assane Diop plays with, turning this invisibility into an almost supernatural strength. For Omar Sy, it's about putting a new face on what it means to be French today. The archetype has changed. The show garnered rave reviews, so we can definitely say that the audience is ready to be progressive. A burglar, a gentleman, a father. Besides being an anti-hero, Arsène is a father. His ex-wife Claire is portrayed by actress Ludivine Sagnier. Have you been wondering why Claire looks so familiar? You may recognize her as Esther Aubrey from the HBO miniseries The Young Pope. She also starred as everyone's favorite fairy, Tinkerbell, in Peter Pan. Director Louis Leterrier, whom she appreciates for his sense of action and adventure, first offered her the role. In Lupin, she has real on-screen chemistry with Omar Sy. I think when Omar is in the room, I have something that lights up inside me. He has this energy that makes me fizz up like a bottle of champagne. In the plot, Claire is an anchor for Assane. It's a reference to his emotional security and the only point of normalcy in his life, along with his teenage son, Raoul. Again, it's all about transmission. Assane inherits the Lupin obsession from his father, then even passing it down to his own son. "It's the first time I play this kind of father, who has a lot of baggage and questions," said Sy, who himself has 5 children. "I'm always interested in fatherhood. It's not easy, and you don't know whether you were a good dad or a bad one until your children are grown up." In real life, this modern French hero is a caring father. His wife once posted his photo saying, "Happy Father's Day to the world's greatest father, husband, protector, and friend. We love you and feel so blessed to have you in our lives." A night at the Louvre. After Beyoncé did it and Jean-Luc Godard had his shot, it's Louis Leterrier's turn to place his camera in the Louvre. In the midst of its treasures, we can find Mona Lisa and that Marie-Antoinette necklace. The story is real. It went missing in the 18th century and has since been the topic of many fictional stories. In the Louvre corridors, we've seen young rebellious Parisians running in the dreamers, as well as the darkest mysteries decrypted in the Da Vinci Code. Even Wonder Woman had her day job as an art historian at the legendary museum. But none of these characters ended up crashing a Ferrari through the famous inverted pyramid, huh? In fact, the Lupin cast and crew had access to its labyrinths on closing days and at night. Even the burglary scene was filmed inside the museum. You may be wondering how shooting took place amongst those priceless artifacts during a lockdown when all museums were closed. For once, the pandemic worked in favor of the filmmakers, as it was easier for them to negotiate with the museum administration. There was no usual 1-kilometer-long queue of visitors, and Omar Sy even spent 20 minutes in an empty room with the Mona Lisa. We were alone in the middle of these incredible works of art. The Louvre is an anthill. When the museum closes, people come out from everywhere to clean the paintings, to move them, recalls Le Terrier. Needless to say, the crime drama is being played in very Parisian locations that will help you get over that other oh-so-French series, Emily in Paris. Here, Paris isn't represented as a postcard with croissants and an Eiffel Tower, but a real city bubbling with life. It's time to switch to a non-Wikipedia version of French life. Breathtaking golf courses in Etretat Normandie, watercolor rooftops, flea markets, and underground suburbs. France undoubtedly has hidden gems. And as promised, that's the third treasure offered by the series, along with Arsène Lupin and Omar Sy. So, what's next? Sequel already in production. We have great news for you guys. It's only the beginning. It's a split season of 10 episodes that have already been shot. We only saw the first part of a big show and the rest could arrive as soon as mid-April. So will Assane learn to approach problems in a new way? His main tool is his head. He has difficulties working with his feelings, explains Omar Sy. He's so attached to his character that he joked about already signing a contract for 36 seasons. All in all, this action-packed series has taught us a lot. I hope it will maybe invite people to read more, Omar Sy says. Sometimes reading can change your life. Tell us, guys, what do you think of this new series? And which book had the biggest impact on you? We can't wait to hear your stories. Thanks for watching, and stay awesome!